Hey, how's it going, everybody? Stargazer 1331 back once again, bringing you Yukimura and Fangore versus my roster. Now, these two appeared in the Dank Lord episode, and I don't, and while I'm pretty sure they didn't win, from what I can tell, let's see. Yeah, I think they lost, but not by much. These two, once they get going, holy crap, are freaking insane. Like, I don't think they're quite as consistent as Hanzo and Super Mario. But once Fangor gets going, especially with the hyper where he's kind of going all around the screen, Yukimura can take full advantage of that shit. And even if Yukimura can get him kind of locked in, Fangor hurts. So, I don't know, man. We'll see what comes out of this. I don't know. I have a feeling the game is... they're probably going to not win as many matches, and there probably won't be as many round threes, but we'll see. Oh, God. Chaos and Kai? What the fuck is this? Don't be... Try not to be as mean to these two as freaking Hanzo and Super Mario, because the game was not kind to them in the slightest, man. Oh my god. Oh my god. Freaking kite and chaos. This team is stupidly good. Chaos is very powerful. Chaos actually hurts. Ow. Ooh, see what I mean, man? Like these two have some potential. Just again, freaking chaos for you. And you're fucked. We're not. Oh my god. Imagine 1v- Oh my god, if he actually wins his 1v1 with only like a sliver- No, man, he could've done it! And the thing is too, if Yukimura is by himself in a 1v1, Yukimura is very hard to stop. He is insanely good. The way his AI is, because in 3v3, 4v4, his AI just kinda like stands there and just constantly parries. But because of that, in 1v1, he is ridiculously good. So if it's ever like a standoff like that, oh baby, yeah, he'll most likely come out on top. Really? Like go from one Sonic character to another? Well, this is gonna be a breather match compared to the last one. These two might still do pretty good, but yeah, these two aren't nearly as broken as Kaid and Chaos. Oh my god. Like, yeah, this is the thing. These two can hurt. Especially if Fangor is protected by Yukimura. Oh my god. I love it how he just patiently just waits there until he's, like, basically, like, almost on the ground, and then he just goes in for the kill. Like, that's what I mean with Fangor. Like, he doesn't charge in the air as much. Like, his AI is very patient. Oh my god. Yeah, I can already tell these two aren't quite as... They're definitely not... They're a little bit less consistent with actually being able to hit targets than Hanzo and Super Mario. They're still a very solid team, though. That shouldn't be discounted at all. Yeah, I would argue maybe in that sense, these two are maybe even slightly more balanced than Hanzo and Super Mario. Yeah, yes, they are right there. There, Sonic, thank you. I would have never guessed. They are right there on the screen. Mm-hmm. Mmm, not bad. All right. This should be energy. This is a team I should consider. Ginyu and Giadel is very good.
I
Like, that's a solidly balanced team right there. Like, very, very capable, but definitely by no means invincible. I'm like freaking Kaiden Chaos. God, what a disgusting team to start off with. Ginyu is still hanging on, dude, by a thread. Oh, never mind, he's gone now. Gino can still hold his own, though, even in a 1v2. Yeah, case in point. Ooh, that was a good counter right there. He actually countered that. Wow, holy crap. That was good. He almost did that by himself. Oh man, good catch. Oh my lordy. Yeah, see, this is why these two would be interesting as a team. And Giadel is gone. Oh my god. Look at Fangore just jumping around, just waiting to get a hit. He's freaking pulling a Dark Donald. He's actually I forgot that Fangore can home in on people. That is actually freaking insane. I forgot that move can home in on people. He literally pulled a Dark Donald. I didn't even know he could fucking do that. Like, I knew he could combo in the air for a while. I didn't think he could, like, Dark Donald that shit.
Like the hoo-ha, hoo-ha, hoo-ha. Like, that's literally what that was.
Oh my god, what the frick. Like, that's the one thing I've noticed. These two are so good, but I've noticed that it takes a little bit sometimes for those moments to happen. Whereas with Hanzo and Mario, they are a hell of a lot more consistent, I feel. Again, still a very, very strong team, but... Really? Of course. Which probably is the reason that these two will probably overall lose a little bit more than Hanzo and Super Mario, because they're just a skosh more inconsistent in terms of actually, like, landing, like, killing combos and shit. And then you get times like this where they're very on point. Right, Harry and Zero Suseva, this is more or less, yeah, that was a flawless. This is more or less a breather match for them. Jeez, man. Ooh, gee, wow, there you go. That was a good hit from Harry. There you go, that's it. Wow. Curtains! Alright. Alright, game. What else you got? Oh, why couldn't it be passive-aggressive cheating? That would've been funny. Okay. Really? From one crossing piece to another? I love when that happens. Freaking Toad Ken. Or Ken Man. Oh, God. That'd be the most meta Capcom joke ever if they actually had freaking Ryu Man or Ken Man. Like, that would be meta as shit, man. A freaking Street Fighter Robot Master, freaking Ken Man or Ryu Man. Or freaking Sagat Man. That's the one thing I've noticed, I think, again, with some of these breather matches, these two are freaking so dominant, but against teams that are definitely on their level, they do struggle a little bit more than Hanzo and Super Mario, by, again, a very small margin. Oh boy, there you go. And ba-boom. Krusty.
Oh my god.
Can we get a third one? That would actually be amazing. I don't even know if Jum has even run into this. I don't even know if this even happened during the Dragonite marathons either. Uh-oh. Oh, that's bad. Oh, that is so bad. Please be regular Juzo. Anticipation? No! Fuck you, game. Damn it. Like, I actually would have kind of liked Renzi and regular Juzo, but no. You just had to ruin it. Freaking master, you piece of goddamn shit. Oh, that is so... Like, you see that combo? That was disgusting. Is it freaking Kaiden Chaos wasn't bad enough? No, these two are arguably worse. Oh, no. Oh, no. Dr. Connor's class. It's so caught up in what I was doing. I forgot all about it. Oh my god, oh, that is so nasty. God, what a combo that is. That is so awful. Oh god. Jesus. Ow. I'll say this, not a bad attempt at all. I mean, they did about as good as they could have done in this match, but that's the sad part. No. No, not, no. Fuck that. I'm not listening to that shit. No. Mm-mm. That was regular Juzo, then fine. Especially if they won via round three. I saw Not Shame, by the way. Oh, come on with this shit. Oh, ugh. Yeah, I'm gonna save y'all the trouble. I'm trolling this shit. No words. Ooh, none. Really, Sweets, Donald? Who are you with? Oh my god, an A-Rock? Oh my jeez, that's a good team. That is an uber nasty team. You dumbass. Like, Fangore, how the fuck are you still alive there? I love magic? Damn, not a bad attempt, though. Yeah, A-Rock is freaking... Really? 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 Of course, you had to steal that from freaking McDonald. McDonald already steals so much stuff, but at least that... Actually, yeah, because he stole that from Donald X. What the fuck? I just realized that. Oh my god. Really? Oh my god. There should be a lot more of a breather match than the last few. Oh my god. Yeah, I'd say they have got to be pissed. I would not blame them in the slightest. Oh god. that's a kind of another thing I've noticed too. Especially if Yukimura goes for the aerial combos. He does so many aerial combos that the damage scaling goes way the hell down if it's a high numbered combo. Whereas Hanzo and Super Mario definitely they didn't run into that problem nearly as much. Da-na-na-na-na-na-na. Yowza. That's it. Yeah, believe me, that was friggin' retribution on for that one. Oh my goodness, man. Alright, here we go. Alright, let's see what else the game can give him. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, not bad. That's right, he's in the house! Here he comes! Cut! Heat! Toast! Cook! Cut. Very nice. You got some heat. Heat. Oh my Jesus. Well, 1v2. Well, never mind. Well, oh yeah, no, Yukimura, you're so fucked. Or should I say Dodori, you're so fucked. Boy, good grab! Keep fighting like that, you're gonna win, dude! Oh my god. Oh yeah, no, you're fucked. Bye! To cook those burgers. Oh, man. That was close, man. Dodori actually had a decent strat going. He should have continued with the grabbing. That would have won him the day. Or the round, rather. Ripardo's saying, oh my god, what the fuck? Interesting team. Oh my god, head crash. And boom, there you go. Wow, good shit, you two. You had to work for that one a bit, but you did it. Oh my god. Oh, I feel like they should have done way more damage. I think you even countered some of that. Oh, that was gonna do like a shitload of damage. See, that's the thing with Rampardos. I wish his AI was a little bit more consistent because he is friggin' strong, dude. Oh god, 1v1. Yukimura should win this, but we'll see. Well, again, not unless Jonathan grabs like that. That'll be an easy win for him. Man, fair enough. Wow, good going, you two. I was actually like, that was just a regular win from a regular team. Like, good. Actually, yeah. Give more of that, and not like the like crazy teams that are just clearly stronger than these two. Like, that would be ideal. Again, I know that's a lot to ask of you, game, but just say, oh man, okay, this one's pretty good. Karateka and Rin, let's go. I mean, if Karateka can get some hits in there, yeah, that'll be easy win for them. He hits like a truck. Damn, wow, boy, that was a sickly combo. And boom, there you go. I mean, the fact they're able to get flawlesses in some of these matches, I think this is their second flawless that they've gotten. It goes to show the power of these two again. I wish these two were just a hair more consistent. Like, I think if either of them was replaced with somebody slightly stronger than the other, then yeah, that consistency would definitely be reached for sure. Or it would be... Oh, hi, Nostalgic Balls. It would be reached way more. Wait a minute. If you take the B from Balls, put it at the beginning of Oob, and then place the Z at the end of it, you get Nostalgic Boobs. That's right. Freaking B-U-U-B-Z. Nostalgic Boobs. Let's go. What the fuck? How do you gain like 3/4 of his health back? No, Nostalgic Boobs, why? Because I remember as I was formulating that in my head, I'm like, oh, like, please spell out boobs, please spell out boobs. Like, oh my god, it actually spells out boobs, let's go. What the hell? I never seen that hyper before. You notice how Oob was not a once the Nostalgic Balls died, Oob was not able to get a hit. And there ends the sad and short tale of Nostalgic Boobs. But if Nostalgic Balls had someone better than Oob that actually was able to survive, yeah, they might Yukimura and Fangore might have lost that round. Just saying. So then, yeah, Oob is, like, one of the weakest characters I have at this point. Like, I don't know. I mean, I guess one good point to have him is that if he's with someone really strong, it kind of balances it out, I suppose. But that's about it. Hyper Justice and Asher, this will be an interesting challenge for them. Let's go. Yeah, they did a really good job isolating them, so fair play on them. Look, I love how fucking patient Yukimura is. Oh man, okay, they are fucked now. And fuck out you. It's like get the fuck away from my partner. Freaking vile heathen. There we go, round three, let's go. Oh my god, he actually countered that. Hold me, that would have friggin' hurt if Yukimura didn't counter that. Yeah, except for the one thing, whenever they do those aerial combos, like the damage scaling really, really hurts these two combo potential. There you go though. Wow, they still got him though, man. Fair enough. Alright, let's do a couple more then. I think we'll call it for this one. I have no idea what team I'm gonna be using next. Oh, hi, not Shane. I saw you. Spiral and Mickey EX. Interesting. Friggin' Spiral Mouse. Why does it sound like a friggin' band name? Spiral Mouse. There's Modest Mouse, but not Spiral Mouse. Oh my god. Ooh. Oh wow, they actually avoided that. Boy, if that hit landed, that would have been a sickly combo from the right side. Oh, and fair enough, Fangor's gone. Oh my lord. Friggin' Yukimura's actually sort of holding his own. That is actually insane. That is kind of the problem, because he expects to... He parries... You see him try to parry so much that, like, grabbing him, it can be a huge weakness for him sometimes. His AI is a little bit almost too finely tuned in that sense. Yeah, I must say, definitely the high-hitting combos, they definitely can't deal as much damage. Which, I mean, well, I will admit, will definitely makes them more balanced than Hanzo and Mario, but with some of the team combos that this game can give, you almost need to have that better damage scaling. Or that more, or that stronger damage scaling in order to friggin' survive and conquer this roster. As, you know, to the best of your ability, you know, RNG, barring the RNG, that is. Yeah, these two are very interesting, for sure. I don't know if it would necessarily warrant me doing another video. I may do another video of them, like, way down the line, but yeah, no, I mean, these two, sadly, are not as consistent as Hanzo. So Hanzo's and Mario are ridiculously consistent, dude. Like, holy crap. This is actually the longest I think I've ever heard of Petty Theft Homer. Aside from actually playing, watching Jump play the mission in, Simpsons Hidden Run. Alright. Yeah, I think we probably have time for one more, then. I think we will call it. Depending on if they get Chibo'd. Mm-hmm. Alright, not bad. Here we go. Friggin' give me some Sugar Shack. Oh, that is so nasty. Because that move can home in along with Yukimura comboing in there. But again, the damage scaling goes down so far. He got a bolt with that. What the fuck? I didn't think you could double target with that. You learn something new every day. What the shit? Yep, and KO. Oh, no, not quite. Oh, you know, I didn't realize Yukimura had so much health left. He freaking back-to-back the both of them. That is it. I didn't think you could get more than one person with that move. Boom. Man, that was close. Holy crap. Yeah, I'll be honest. I mean, I do like them in the sense that this is a more balanced... I thought this team was, would be more busted, but it's they're really not. Like, that's really, I guess, maybe the takeaway. This is maybe one reason why I would show them again, now that I'm thinking about it a little bit more. Yeah, these two are honestly surprisingly balanced. Like I thought... I figured these two would be more busted, like Hanzo and Mario. Oh, yes. My god, nice. He actually did that. There you go, man. Final round. Let's go, man. Wow, what a fucking way to end this episode. Ooh. Oh, wait, oh, I got interrupted by the giant friggin' Buster Sword from Sanosuke. I mean, I say surprisingly balanced, but you gotta look at it also in the terms of my roster. Again, for most balanced rosters, this team is pretty goddamn brutal. But not for this roster. That's the beauty of it. And boom, there you have it. Good shit, you guys. There you go. Yukimura and Fangore. Not a bad team. I came into this episode thinking they would be more broken, but they're actually kind of balanced to the point where I honestly wouldn't mind using them again. With the expectation they're not going to win as many battles as some other teams, but, you know, they're still pretty good in their own right. So, in any case, I don't know what team I'm going to do next. I'll try to maybe search through the last few videos, see if I can find anyone good. Hell, I might even use one of DL's teams again, but... Till next time, guys. I will see you later.